Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a beautiful, dramatic nighttime image filled with infinite stars abounding the sky, a bright full moon, and exquisite nebulas spanning the cosmos, all from a daytime photo. This is an update of a tutorial I did a few years ago. This update is more nuanced and effective. It's for Photoshop versions CS6 and later. I provided this photo that you can download of a sandstone tower called the Organ that I shot in Arches National Park in Utah. Its link is in my video's description below or in my project files. Feel free to use another photo if you like. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to my channel, click the small subscribe button at the lower right corner. The first step is to make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. In this copy, we'll separate the land from the sky. To do this, open your Quick Selection tool and drag it over the sky to select it. In this particular case, since all of the land has hard edges, there's no reason to refine the selection's edges. However, if you're using a different photo in which the land has some soft edges, go to Select and click Select and Mask, or in earlier versions, click Refine Edge. I did in-depth tutorials for both of these filters, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their respective links in my video's description. To ensure that the land won't have a light-colored fringe surrounding it, we'll expand the selection inward by clicking Modify and Expand. Expand it 1 pixel. To see that the selection covers the entire sky, press Q on your keyboard to see it as a quick mask. Then revert it back into a selection by pressing Q again. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Color Lookup. Open the Load 3D LUT flyout list and click Moonlight.3DL. I'll drag down the Layers panel to expand it. Next, we'll replace the sky with gradient colors. First, click the New Layer icon to create a new layer. We'll fill it with black, but first, check your foreground and background colors. If they're not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Gradient Overlay. Make sure the style is linear. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the black-white gradient preset and the lower left stop. Click the color box to open the color picker. In the hexadecimal field, type in FFBD0B. Then click OK. Click the lower right stop and the color box. Type in 000823. Click below the gradient bar to add another stop. For its location, I'll type in 25%. However, if you're using a different photo whose horizon line is higher or lower than this one, feel free to adjust the location of this middle stop. Click the color box and type in 00249A. Then click OK on all three windows to close them. Go to the layer mask and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it next to the gradient layer. Rename the layer Gradient Sky. To save some space, collapse the effect. Make a new layer and fill it with black. Name it Stars. We'll convert it into a smart object by clicking the icon at the upper right and clicking Convert to Smart Object in case we want to change the setting amounts of the filters that we'll be using to create the stars. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. The amount is 100%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.3 pixels. Open Levels by pressing Ctrl or Command L. For the input shadows, type in 120, and for the input midtones, type in 0.20. The stars are very subtle now, but they'll brighten up once we add a filter to them later. Let's collapse the effects to save space. Change the blend mode to screen. To hide the stars that are in front of the land, go to the top layer mask and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it next to the stars layer. Since stars tend to be less visible the closer they are to the horizon, we'll make those stars less visible. To do this, make the layer mask active that's next to the stars. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft, round brush. For its size, I'll type in 700 pixels. Its hardness is 0% and the opacity is 50%. Go to one side of the horizon and brush across to the opposite side. This makes the stars that we brushed over appear dimmer. Make a new layer and name it Nebulas. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Next, we'll angle the clouds in perspective, but first, we need to zoom out of our image to give us more room. Press Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard a few times. I zoomed it out to 16.67%. Go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. Go to a top corner and drag it out approximately this much. Then press Enter or Return. Since the clouds extend way past our canvas, we'll crop the extended parts off by pressing Ctrl or Command A to select the document and going to Image and Crop. Then deselect it. To zoom back in, press Ctrl or Command and the plus key a few times, or you can press Ctrl or Command plus 0 to fill the canvas with your image. Change the blend mode to Color Dodge. To hide the clouds over the land portions, go to the stars layer mask and as before, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it next to the nebula's layer. To make the most of the cloud's perspective, we'll drag the bottom up to just below the horizon line. First, click off the chain link icon to unlink the layer and the layer mask. This will allow us to move or resize either of them independently of the other. Click the clouds to make it active, and press Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. Go to the bottom middle of the bounding box, and if you're using a version earlier than CC 2019, drag it up to just under the horizon. However, if you are using version 2019 or later, press and hold the Shift key as you drag up the bounding box. Then press Enter or Return. We'll make a new layer below the active layer by Ctrl-clicking or Command-clicking the New Layer icon. Go to the Gradient Sky layer mask and drag a copy of it next to the empty layer. Name it Nebulas Colors. Click the foreground color and pick a bright color. If you want to make your brush smaller, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the left bracket key on your keyboard. Reduce its opacity to 10 to 20%. Gently brush over areas of the sky which adds color and brightens it. Next, we'll add a full moon. Click the top layer to make it active, and make a new layer above it. Name it Moon. Open your elliptical marquee tool and feather it 2 pixels. Click on your document and don't release your mouse or pen. Press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag out a circle approximately this size. Click your foreground color and in the hexadecimal field type in FFF5BC. Copy the color by either writing down its hexadecimal code or highlighting it with your cursor and then pressing Ctrl or Command C to copy it to your clipboard. To fill the selection with that color, press Alt or Option plus Delete, then deselect it. Double-click the thumbnail of the moon layer to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow and the color box. Type or paste in the color you copied into the hexadecimal field and click OK. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 65%, the spread is 0%, and the size is 60 pixels. We'll convert the moon with its outer glow into a smart object because we're going to add another outer glow to it. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow again, and make sure the color is the same as the first one. Make the opacity 25%, the spread 20%, and the size 250 pixels. Lastly, we'll brighten slivers of the land where it catches the moonlight. Scroll down and click the Color Lookup layer mask. We're going to brush black in it, so to make your foreground color black, press D on your keyboard. If the colors are inverted, press X. To protect the sky from our brush strokes, Ctrl-click or Command-click the Layer 1 layer to make a selection of its shape. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Hide the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command H. The selection is still there, it's just hidden. Open your brush tool and brush picker. I'll make its size 20 pixels, but feel free to adjust the amount. The hardness is 0% and the opacity is 100%. Brush over the areas of the rock formations that are already brighter to reveal their original brightness. They're a bit too bright for moonlight, so we'll dim them. First, invert your colors so white is your foreground color. Enlarge your brush to approximately this size and decrease the brush's opacity to 50%. Brush once across the top half of your image and once across the bottom half. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.